Kia ora, Chrissy back again, and we're going to get into the next episode of Better Call Saul.
Like, comment, and subscribe, please.
So last time we had plan and execution, the execution side of it being Howard Hamlin, shot in the head by Lalo in front of Kim and Jimmy. It was horrendous. The plan that Jimmy and Kim had put into motion went flawlessly for them, and it ended in Howard's murder. Of course, I mean, it's not their fault that he was murdered, but you know, it was just a tragic kind of side effect of everything else that was going on with Lalo and Gus, and this, you know, him wanting to find out what's going on with the laundromat, and now that he knows that that Hector's being bugged. So yeah, Lalo knows that Gus knows that he is around. So everything's just kind of like really hit the fan here. What are they going to do with Howard? How are they going to explain it? I have an idea, and I guess it makes sense, the idea that I have. But I guess we'll just have to wait and see. If you like the full-length reaction to this episode, as well as others in the series and other shows, then you can go to my Patreon. The link will be down in the description box below. If you don't want to do that, that's fine. Just giving this video a like, commenting, subscribing to my channel, any of that will help as well. Okay, so let's get into this next episode. Oh, okay. Not picking up straight off. Not exactly the kind of ending that you can just kind of sweep under the... Okay, is this supposed to be Howard's shoe? They've thrown him in the ocean. Oh no. Okay. This is what I thought. That's not exactly how I thought. I had the inkling that they were going to make it out that he killed himself. But I don't know why. I just thought it was going to be like they're going to call the cops to, you know, Jimmy's place, and you know, that Howard had come over in a rage and had offed himself in front of them. But they've set up this whole scene, it looks like, that he's done it at the beach. I guess it kind of makes sense. I hate it so much. Everything that's happened to Howard this season, I've hated it. Every minute of it.
Come on. Sit. I was on your side the whole time.
I don't care.
My car's downstairs. This is where you are going. In the glove compartment, I left you a present. There's a camera and there's a gun, and you're gonna need both.
A gun?
So you go up to that house, you walk right up to that black door. You ring the bell, you count to three, door opens, you point, and you shoot.
Oh my God!
You keep on pulling that trigger until it's empty.
Look, you can do this, okay? This guy, he's a house cat.
Black, medium height, short hair, glasses. But don't be fooled. Even a house cat can scratch. Take a picture, one where I can see the face clearly, and then you bring it back here where me and Mrs. Goodman will be waiting for you. And then you're done.
Well, clearly that doesn't happen.
You're back here in an hour, or...
Send her. What? She should do it.
Doesn't want to be left alone with you.
This guy, the house cat.
Jimmy, please.
He looks through his peephole in the middle of the night and he sees me, but he sees a woman. She looks like she's in distress. Maybe her car broke down.
It's plausible.
Yeah, but she's really clever. I don't know if she's going to stick to the plan.
She will.
No.
You know she can
do
it. You know I'm right.
Stop. Just stop. Listen, stop it.
Okay, fine. Yeah, her. Whatever. Give her the keys. Give her the address. Let's go.
He just wants to get her out.
Don't.
She'll come up with something.
Okay, so 1 hour starting now.
How bad is it that all the planning and that Jimmy and Kim have done to do this awful, awful shit to Howard? And I fucking hate the way that the smugness of Kim and Jimmy, but mainly Kim, it really puts me against her character. However, I don't want her to be harmed here. I'm hoping that she's going to come up with a plan to, you know, fucking get out of this. Clearly something happens because, you know, sending her to go and kill Gus, Gus doesn't die. So I'm guessing something's going to happen. That all this could really like turn me against her character. Yet Lalo kills Howard. He's a bona fide murderer. Like, he doesn't give a shit. I love his character. Fuck. I'm so terrible.
After I saw you last, I went home. My home. You know what happened? Men came. You know what they did? They killed people I care about. How did these men...
Oh, it was Nacho. He didn't figure that out, okay?
No idea.
How? Ignacio Varga.
Oh, he did. Okay.
He let them in. And who did Ignacio introduce me to? You.
You gotta believe me. Hand to God, I had no part in this. It wasn't me. It was the guy.
Ignacio.
He knows enough about me already. Too much, in fact.
Ford Taurus.
Jim Ford.
So.
I had a date with him. What'd you find out about Tom?
That's really loud.
Brother, you got patience.
Take it easy.
How can anybody get to be so dumb?
Well, we can't all know everything, Harry.
Oh, you're going to fall right into his blood.
What?
I can just imagine it.
Well, I care who he is.
Oh.
Which of his books did you like best?
I thought he was going to fall right into his blood. In that face.
I didn't know any rabbits.
Think you're so smart, huh? What are you, some kind of genius or something?
No.
I hire and fire genius.
Oh, she is shaking. Look, it's a place. No? Okay. I know she wanted to. Is Mike's people, like, not following her anymore? Or did they pull them off? They pulled them off, like, her and Jimmy to watch Gus? Is that right? People should be watching her. Wouldn't they be getting suspicious about why she's walking up there? It's not going to be Gus that answers the door. It's going to be Mike. He knows of her. Oh, they're behind you. It is Mike. She was actually going to do it. I'm kind of proud of you. Kind of proud of you for your conviction.
What are you doing? I have to go, man.
Miss Wexler, I'd like you to sit down.
Now you take a deep breath. Nothing's going to happen here until you calm yourself.
Lalo is going to kill Jimmy. He's there. He is there with Jimmy.
Salamanca's at your apartment?
Yes, he sent me.
What were you supposed to do here?
Shoot him.
Well, not him, but...
To shoot him and then take a photo and then get back. That's it. I only have 20 minutes left, please. He is alone with him.
You stay put. We'll handle this. We will handle this. You called Tyrus. Get him to the condo now.
You said you were watching us. Where were you?
He's a decoy, that guy, but yeah, I guess hearing that Lalo really is there kind of really solidifies it, eh? Like, they had their suspicions pretty founded suspicions, but now it's fact. Oh, he's too good, he knew. Oh, this is the laundromat. Oh, gonna get them all to go over there, and he's gonna go into the laundromat. Fuck, okay. Oh. Oh, well, no one's watching because... Oh, fuck, that was lucky. I mean, come on, that was way too lucky.
Put her on. Why did Lalo send you?
He didn't want to send me, not at first. But my husband talked him out of it because he wanted to get me out of there.
He... talked Lalo out of it.
That's right.
He's gonna put it together. Nothing can talk Lalo out of anything.
Come with me, both of you.
All right, hold the perimeter. Everyone else on me, eyes sharp. Nice and easy. We don't want to spook the neighbors.
God, Mike's such a badass. Oh, yep. He knew. He knew. He had an inkling. Remember, there's that gun down there. So much for hunkering down, Gus. God, he's clever. He can pick out this shit, you know? He's bent. Holy shivers. Should have stayed hunkered down. We know it's not going to end here for Gus, so.
All right, I need to know where Salamanca went, and I need to know exactly how long he's been gone.
I don't know where he went. He left right after she did.
Don Eladio, mira nada más a quién tenemos aquí. Al mismísimo Gustavo Fring.
Your gun's down there, buddy. They tell me he's going to kill Lalo. Oh.
Tenemos como... 13 minutos antes de que llegue su gringo pelón y la caballería, así que Gustavo os va a dar un tour rápido.
Oh. Shit, right over the heart.
Qué maravilla. Yo tenía una tina que hacía algo muy parecido, pero honor a quien honor merece, esto está mucho mejor. Hijo de puta.
Don't tell me. Oh, I like Lalo. I don't want to see him die. Even though he's a bad guy.
Okay, drum roll, please.
Ta-da. Guns down there.
¿Qué tal eso? Wow, ¿no? Don Eladio, he escuchado algunas historias sobre este lugar. Unos ingenieros alemanes se tardaron 10 meses en construir todo esto.
Gustavo pensaba que estaba armando un imperio y lo único que estaba haciendo era cavar su propia tumba.
I know where this goes, so... Well, the lab at least.
Eladio. El patrote hinchado y grasoso. Hablas de honor. Pero no tienes ni una gota. Chacales. Eso es todo lo que son. Sin visión, ni paciencia, ni idea.
How long has he been...
Impulsivo.
How long has he been holding on to this, you know?
Y usted los Salamancas son peores parásitos que hay. Héctor, I kept him alive. Kept him broken. I will save him to the last. Before he dies, he will know I buried every one of you.
You done?
No. Not yet.
Shit, there wasn't much in there, was there? Fuck off, he did not. To happen. Oh, he's not coming back from that. Gotta watch him die. Man, disappointed. I don't know, it just seemed too easy that it's over that quickly. I hope all like the cops in the fucking state have like body armor like that.
You happy with the way things went down tonight? Cause I'm not. How'd you know Lalo would be at the laundry?
I didn't.
Well, the next time you get a wild hair to play detective, tell me. This could have gone down a whole lot different.
It could have.
Why does he seem so upset? You won!
Here's what's going to happen. In a few days, Howard Hamlin's car will be found several states away by the water. There will be cocaine in the upholstery. That's the story you were setting up for this guy, yeah? They'll call it a suicide, hoping the body will come washing up. It never will. Cops are gonna wanna hear from you. You tell the cops you saw him. He came here. Seemed like maybe he was chemically altered. Then he left, that's all you know. You keep telling the lie that you've been telling. None of this ever happened. None of it. Say it out loud. I need to hear it.
We understand.
Kim?
It never happened.
Well, what can you say, really? Oh my god. Okay, so... But I fucking hate how this is how it ended for bloody Howard. They buried him down there? Like, it's fine for Lalo, you know, he kind of deserves to be, like, put here. But Howard? Wallet in his ring. Oh, and his shoes, of course.
Easy.
Yeah, throw him in the hole nicely. Fuck. Get those fucking cellos out of here.
Thank you.
hate that. I hate that ending for Howard. You know, after everything that he'd been put through, after all the shit that he had to deal with after Chuck's, you know, suicide, and just finally, you know, that he was able to kind of pull himself out of that, even, you know, only to have like his marriage start to fall apart. And then just the constant, you know, passive aggressiveness from bloody Jimmy, and then everything that, you know, that Jimmy and Kim together did to him. And like, it was just fucking dragged through the mud, treated like shit by them, through no fault of his own. I don't care, you know, about the argument that he had with Chuck. Yeah, I don't care about him fucking saying that, you know, it's probably a good idea that Chuck retires. I don't care about any of that. He wasn't wrong. And then just see how he ended up chucked in a fucking hole with Lalo Salamanca. Really sad, sad fucking ending for him. Otherwise, the rest of this episode was amazing. So I'm just disappointed in like just the easy death of Lalo. I mean, I guess not every death has to be, you know, someone going out in a blaze. But for him to like just be taken out by a couple of shots, a few shots from Gus, I don't know. I guess I was just expecting something a little bit more. But and like I said, in, you know, earlier in the episode, I'm such a hypocrite for really enjoying, you know, the murderous character of Lalo, because he's just so charming. And even though, like I said, he killed Howard, like that character, but hate the character that Kim's become. Though, I mean, I have sympathy for her. I have empathy for her, but just because of what happened here, not because of what she put him through, put Howard through. It was really, really good though, this whole episode. How Kim and Jimmy are going to go, how they're going to be going forward. Like, this has definitely changed, especially Kim, I think. You know, Jimmy's kind of seen like a lot of shit already, like out in the desert, you know, when he got fired upon. He's seen a lot of shit already. So he's like, he is almost there 100% soul. But Kim, this is going to affect her some way. Especially, I mean, I hope there is a part of them that feels guilty for what they did to Howard. I hope there is. I don't know if there will be, but I hope there is. Would it even be right to say Howard wouldn't have even gone around there to bloody have a go at them if they hadn't done what they did? So now that Lalo is dead, who is going to be like our main kind of antagonist? Are we going to have to deal with the cartel again? Hector? I don't know. Is Tuco going to be getting out of jail soon? He's a crazy bastard. But I mean, I guess we deal with him in Breaking Bad. But yeah, this was really good. Very sad ending. Hate seeing bloody Lalo go out like that. Definitely hate seeing what happens to Howard. And I'm not very happy with Jimmy or Kim. So yeah, that was a lot of fun to watch though. Okay, well, we're going to leave it there for today. Thank you for joining with me. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And we'll see you next time for more Better Call Saul. See ya.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. We'll see you next time.